Here at Tormach, we want to share your customer stories. So here's Daniel Hienzsch, who's working on some high-end innovation at Supplyframe.
Hi, I'm Daniel Hienzsch, and I'm the resident engineer at Supplyframe's design lab in Pasadena, and we are the proud owners of a Tormach PCNC 1100. When Supplyframe was talking to me about taking over the design lab, they kept talking about the different equipment that they had there, but they kept talking about this thing called the Tormach. But I really didn't know it until I looked on the website. I was like, okay, so Tormach, that must be the machining equipment that they purchased. And when I finally went there, I walked into the workshop, the motion detector sensed that I was in there and the lights all come on like this and they all light up the Tormach, which is sitting like that slab from 2001, just in the middle of the room. And I walked up to it and it says, you know, personal CNC. Like, what is personal about this? This thing is huge. And it was, you know, within 2 or 3 days, I'd signed up for the Tormach mill class. So I got to, you know, I'm not just going to let that thing sit there. You got to start beating on it somehow.
That's awesome.
So the design lab exists for a number of purposes. The area where the Tormach really comes in is in where we're fostering engineering teams. So we bring teams in to develop their projects, and part of that project will inevitably always involve some sort of enclosure or fabrication of a housing or some structural element within it. I have the good fortune, with the full backing of the company that I work for, to be able to make a lot of mistakes. And it's turned out that the Tormach is very forgiving in that regard. So I regularly crash the end mills. Fortunately, I haven't crashed it too hard, but apparently I'm one of the few people that's ever snapped a TTS holder right at the spindle. But you know, you have to make mistakes in order to gain the experience. And that's good because a lot of the engineers that we wind up working with have some brilliant ideas in terms of what they want to build, but don't necessarily have that experience in fabrication or in manufacturing or in machining. The design lab functions as a place to take all the stuff that we do in the virtual world, which is Hackaday, hackaday.io, and that much larger community, and give it a physical reality, a place where we can actually take the ideas that these people are having, that these engineers are developing, and give them a place to grow. So consequently, for those teams that we invite into the design lab, we have all this fabrication equipment, of which the Tormach is an essential part. One of the teams that we recently had in was working on a 4-month residency. It was called the Perceptive Scope, and that's a coin-operated binocular system, except it's augmented reality. So he's able to overlay computer graphics on top of the real world within his enclosure. The bearing blocks in there had to be of substantial size, and it's not the sort of thing that you can just get away with through 3D printing. Then we take it to the Tormach, and then you actually fabricate it out of aluminum that we got at a wholesaler in town. So another project that we worked on at the lab was a camera mounting system that had Canon 5DSs mounted at 120 degrees from each other, but also canted at 30 degree angles. And then with one camera pointing straight up, so a 4-camera system. And also, can you have us a prototype within 24 hours? And if we like the prototype, can you build it for us within a week? And foolishly, I said, of course. So just to test it out, I prototyped everything with MDF. But they said, you know what, we stitched the photos together, it worked, so go ahead, we need it. So over the course of Labor Day weekend, I 3 days, about 28 hours worth of work, everything was machined. To hit everything with the Superfly. So, you know, they got this just mirror polished object back. Apparently they told me that it worked great in the desert, but it got them over that sort of like, this isn't a piece of junk, this isn't like some hacked together thing. So Supplyframe sponsors a design and engineering challenge each year, and the winner of that prize gets $100,000 and then a residency at the design lab. And for that endeavor, I was asked to actually build the trophy. I wanted it to be a weighty trophy. So I thought maybe a 4-inch block of aluminum would be cool. And I wound up recessing the trophy logo onto each of the faces, which sort of looks like a little space invader, like, right? So that was a lot of fun to fabricate. And I gotta say, the Tormach support, and I don't want this to sound like I'm the sales pitch for Tormach, but the Tormach support, I've talked with John for an hour and a half. And it would be a matter of, okay, I'm gonna go take the motor off, and I'd put my phone down for 20 minutes and sit there and get the motor off, and then I'd pick the phone back up and say, hey, you still there, John? Oh yeah, I'm still here. You know, I mean, that that shows tenacity on the part of support. That's very satisfying to me, to be able to talk with somebody that is willing to spend the time to make sure that the problem actually gets fixed.
Thanks for watching. Check out all of our latest videos here. And for more metalworking tips, tricks, and stories, subscribe to our YouTube channel.